Hey guys, how's it going? Alright, tonight I'm having. Oops, I'm sure this or not. Quesadilla, with a little bit of chopped onion, green onion on top, with salsa, with a little bit of onion mixed in. So I'm hoping. This is a cheese quesadilla, by the way. I'm hoping this is good because I accidentally charred on the underside. So this might be a little interesting to eat. I'm famous for burnt offerings, by the way. That's why I usually don't cook. When I used to work doing pizza, it was easier because you pop it in the oven and it just went on the conveyor belt for a few minutes and wham bam. Trying to fry stuff. So yeah, I'm hoping that doesn't ruin the taste too much. But I really don't want to have to redo the tortilla. But I might have to. I don't know. Let me try this. We'll see how horrible they are. Tastes not too bad. Not like I thought it was going to be. The salsa actually helps tone the charred flavor down a little bit. So how you guys doing? Good, I hope. Hope you had a good week so far. I think I've lost all my onion that I had actually put on my quesadilla. I didn't have any sour cream or guacamole or anything like that, so. It's just cheese, tortilla, and salsa. But yumminess. Yum. Not so yum, but actually, I don't really taste it with. I put the salsa on. Did I just stick my elbow into? Something was cold, but I don't see anything there. Yeah, I forgot I need to get my drink. Got to put it in the freezer to help get it cold. The cold, whatever it was that I put my elbow on, is what reminded me of my cold drink. One second here. Yeah, I was worried about that ruining the taste. It's like, I really don't want to have to redo. I hate redoing stuff. Tonight I have something different. I've never tried these, so I hope this is good. Kickstart Mountain Dew. Black Cherry. Kickstart Black Cherry Mountain Dew. I'm guessing it's a energy drink? I don't know. I'm just hoping it tastes good. That is good. Wow. I like that. I'm tired tonight. It's been a long day. It feels like 2 days, 2 or 3 days rolled up into one. I stayed up all night. Trying to get that paperwork done, disability paperwork done for my husband. Still got a little bit more to go. And at the crack of dawn at 8 a.m., because he had a toothache. Well, two toothaches. I called the dentist office thinking I could get him into the dentist office today Hopefully. No. They open it, usually open at 8 a.m. So that's why I called at 8 a.m. Come find out if it's an emergency situation, you have to call at 7 a.m. in order to get an appointment. So because of it, all their emergency appointment slots were filled up already at 8 a.m. Like, wow. So I couldn't get him into the dentist. And here I am feeling horrible because he is in so much pain. Two toothaches, his kidney pain, and then this neuropathy pain. I was like, poor guy. But. Oh, so a little bit while later, I called. Oh, come find out. They weren't. How do I say it? Well, I called back again later. I tried to get him, see if I can get an appointment set for a regular appointment, but you know, not an emergency appointment. No. They, how do I say it, aren't taking any new adult patients right now. So, in order for him to have gotten in, I would have had to call at 7 a.m. tomorrow to hopefully get appointment, emergency appointment, because there's no slots for to become a new patient, I guess you say. Like, but so then a couple hours later, his cheek was swollen because of the toothache, so I called the doctor's office and inquired about getting him an emergency appointment to get him some antibiotics at least. And I was hoping for some pain pills for his toothache. They didn't give him anything like that. They actually called back a little while later, and excuse me, we had like 25 minutes to get there for appointment. They asked if we could be there at 3 p.m. It's like, yes, we'll be there. So I helped him get dressed and everything. I have to help him get dressed sometimes with his shorts and underwear and socks and shoes because he has trouble sometimes with all that, with the neuropathy, his hands and feet. But so I helped him get dressed, and we got there on time, and I got him into the doctor's office. So I got him some antibiotics, get that swelling down. It's kind of funny. I had a toothache. It was all swollen up 2 weeks ago, and now he's taking a turn only with two teeth. Because he was a little jealous. So I'm glad I at least got him into the doctor's office. I'm tired, but he's worth it to lose sleep over. Oh my God. Do y'all think he's a comedian on here? You should have heard him in the doctor's office. He had them roaring laughing. It was funny. The nursing staff and the doctor. He is such a goofball. We had just started going there like 2 months ago. They love him. They think he's funny. They have a kick out, you know, when he comes in there. But you know, a lot of people, they go into the office and they fill out the paperwork and they just sit there and wait. My husband's over there, and we get there, he's sitting over there making jokes with the nursing staff and the receptionist and all that kind of stuff, and flirting. So, which flirting, and not in a it'll piss Vicky off sort of way. I know he's just playing around, so yeah, it was all fun just flirting. The one gal, she handed me a pin that had a flower on the top of it, and so I could sign the check. Well, I handed it back to him to hand to her because he was closer. he was kidding around and telling her, shh, don't tell my wife. My wife, I gave you a flower. Here I am standing right there. She was cracking up laughing. He's good for them. I love this clinic down here. They actually have a sense of humor. They're funny, nice, quick. Whereas the clinic we used to go to for several years, it was stick of the mud. They all acted like they had corn cob up their butt or something. So, huge difference. I just wish I could have got him into the dentist office today to get those teeth pulled. But at least I did get him into the doctor's office. So, and because of the tooth problem and him being diabetic and everything, the doctor is actually inquiring about getting him into the to be a patient, a dental patient, so he can get those teeth removed. Because they're just going to keep causing problems. So, the one is cracked and everything. Because, I think mostly because the diabetes and stuff has affected his body. So, anywho, sorry. I don't mean to ramble. Just, it's been a long day. Hope I didn't gross anybody out with the little frog. He was just so cute. I'm glad I was able to save him. I could have, when he was stuck to the ice, I thought he was dead. But even if he was dead, I felt bad for him and I didn't want to just rip his leg off that was stuck to the ice. I took a little stick and I gently chiseled the ice away around his foot and got his foot unstuck and got him up out of the ice all in one piece. And I'm glad I did, because when I laid him down on the wooden railing is when I realized he was still alive. It's like, oh my goodness, he wasn't dead. So that's why I brought him in and tried to warm him up. So I'm glad I survived. He was so cute though. That's the downfall of living here near the woods, and it'd be a lot of moisture and everything, is tree frogs everywhere. But they're so cute. Well, I think they anyway. So. But if you watch the video and you don't like frogs, you've been warned. It may be cringy. I put a warning on there. This is actually good. Yum, yum, yum. Watch. I drink this, I'll be up all night. I'm not trying to be up all night. Tonight I want to sleep. Last night I wanted to sleep too, but I couldn't. I was just too stressed. Worried. Oops. A lot of chunkies here. All my onion I'm adding. Get on there. Oh, man. It's been a long time since my lighting. Look like a pale ghost. But, wow. Talk about a distraction there. But yeah, it's been a long time since I've had quesadillas. Probably a couple years, actually. bad. I haven't got to figure out what to do with her fur. This is her scratching post thingy. It's supposed to hang up like that from a doorknob, but my husband actually pulled the doorknob thingy off when we got it. So usually it's on the floor. But all those little pieces of cardboard, you see that we're rolling up. Make a mess here. You see that roller or not? Well, that gets in her long fur, and her fur is getting more and more and more knotted up every single day. So I'm probably gonna have to. She loves this thing. She sleeps with it. She hugs it. Scratches it. But I hate to do it. I'm probably gonna have to take it away from her temporarily while trying to get her fur detangled, if I can. I'm almost wondering if I'm going to have to shave her. If I do, that's going to be fun. Hot. She gets mad at me as it is when I try to brush her, which I understand because it probably hurts with all those knots of fur being pulled. I try to be gentle, but she's got so much matted hair because of that stuff that it's going to take forever to get that clip, brushed out. I have some sharp scissors someplace, but I can't find them ever since we moved. I'll figure to clip out the matted fur, but I can't find them. My mom, she tried 4 different pairs of scissors the other day of hers, but they're all so old and dull that they wouldn't work. They wouldn't cut through anything. So I'm not sure what to do with her fur. She literally has like 3 or 4 inch long fur. And it's all feeling gross because it's all knotted up underneath. On the outside, when looking at her, if I held her up here right now, you couldn't see it real well that she has all kinds of knots in her fur. But when you pick her up and pet her and stuff, it's like, ew. So I don't know what to do if I'm. Anybody got any ideas, any suggestions? Only thing I'm thinking is either keeping her scratchy thing from her for a while I slowly. Work on brushing her daily. It's going to take a while because I hate inflicting pain on her. I hate it. I'm making her mad. But and the only other thing I think of is shaving her, which I don't know if you're really supposed to do that with cats like that. I know I've seen a lot of cats online that have been shaved, but because of their body temperature and stuff like that, are you really supposed to? I don't know. So, I don't know what to do. Just, I don't know, all those knots is like, gross. Gross, gross. So yeah, if anybody has any ideas, suggestions, I don't have money to take her to vet or anything like that, so whatever I do, I have to do myself. It's going to be fun. I just might have to just do it the slow way and maybe let her have her scratchy like a few minutes at a time with adult supervision, so to speak. You know, a few minutes at a time a day that I take away and then brush her out some more. That way she doesn't. But otherwise, she scratches it all the time and then she gets all that stuff loosened. And then she rolls in it, is what it is. Anywho, finish up here. I'm rambling out tonight, sorry. She was such, seriously, such a good girl, though. I have literally never had such a good... I've had a lot of cats over the years. I can honestly say she is the best cat I've ever had. As far as, like, snuggling, and she doesn't even get up on the... She'll get, even here in the kitchen, she'll get up in the chair, but she won't get up on the table. She doesn't get try to get up to the counters. None of that. She won't even get into an empty box. She won't even look in an empty box or a bag or anything like that. Every other cat I've ever had loved boxes. Empty boxes. Not her. Strange cat. She barely plays. I mean, she has played that. I don't... Maybe she's an older cat or something. I don't know. I got her as a stray. Yeah, but she doesn't even look in a... Even my old cat that I used to have, my 18-year-old cat, still loves boxes. This one's strange. I was like, what cat does not love boxes? Oh, so that was like a standard thing with cats. Yeah, a little bit burnt. I chased it a little more on that one. Burnt offering. You see that or not? The cheesiness. Yum! Money no salsa. I need to pour some more and I really don't want to. I think I'm gonna finish that off camera so I can do my shout outs real quick. I know I don't have to do these every night, but it's fun. Shout out to Audrey. Hi, Tyler. Tyler Remy. There's a shout out right there. First one is the Chantel Eating Show. Number two is V Loves to Cook and Eat. Number three is Candy Cakes. Four is Smash Mama. Number five is Mukbang Mama. Go check these guys out. Alright, I'm gonna scoot. So I at least hopefully attempt to get a little bit of sleep. So talk to you guys later. Bye bye.